Today, we will learn what is globalization. You must have heard this word a lot of time, but exactly what does it mean? Let us find out. Have a look at this Japanese advertisement.
This advertisement showed how Japanese are also trying to learn Hindi, our national language. Now, what is the need for Japanese to learn Hindi?
They are learning Hindi because they want to interact with the Indian traders and merchants so as to have good trade relations with them. In today's world, all the major countries have trade relations with one another.
Since early history, global trade has been connecting various countries in different ways. Silk Route in ancient times helped in connecting Asia from the rest of the world. This trade route not only facilitated movement of goods, but also movement of people and ideas. International migration was common even back then. It is estimated that over 50 million people emigrated around Europe to America and Australia. Large number of Chinese and Indian laborers went to work on plantations, in mines and construction business around the world as a part of the colonial plan. If zero traveled from India to rest of the world, then Western clothes came to India.
Need of cost cutting. Suppose a company is having two options to get a particular work done. The first option is to get it done in the home country, but cost involved will be higher. Next option is to get it done in a different country at a lesser cost. Obviously, any company will prefer the second option.
Labor cost and cost of certain raw materials are cheaper in India, Malaysia, China, and Taiwan. This results in reduced cost of production, which will result in better profit for the company. The final product is then exported to the market where it will be ultimately used.
Every company's main aim is to increase the clientele for their products. International markets are obviously more lucrative and beneficial than the domestic markets. The various ways in which MNCs set up or controls production in other countries are by buying out domestic companies or making the latter work for them.
Sometimes MNCs buy mass produce of domestic industries and then sell it under their own brand name at much higher rates in foreign countries. MNCs look towards developing nations to set up trade because in such places the labor and manufacturing costs are much lower. Foreign trade leads to integration of markets across countries by the process of imports and exports. Producers can make available their goods in markets beyond domestic ones via exports.
Likewise, buyers have more choice on account of imports from other countries. This is how markets are integrated through foreign trade.
For example, Japanese electronic items are imported to India and have proved to be a tough competition for less technologically advanced companies here. Most of us buy Samsung TVs rather than buying Tesla or BPL, right?